What Typically presents the top 10 PC games for the last 5 years, all arranged by PlayScore. To check out our full list, visit our website at whattoplay.com. You can also take part in our rankings by leaving reviews of the games you played. Before we start with number 10, this video is sponsored by Opera GX. The future of gaming is about to get more convenient with the Opera GX gaming browser. You might be asking, a gaming browser? How is that even possible? The Opera GX gaming browser has built-in GX control, and it's the perfect solution for what to players with low-end PCs that are having a hard time gaming when a browser is on. It can let you integrate all your favorite gaming tools, including Twitch, Spotify, Twitter, and Discord in one sidebar. Switching seamlessly between playing a game and checking on your friends only takes seconds. With GX Control, Opera's gaming browser improves your gaming performance by giving you the choice to limit your CPU's RAM and even your internet speed to prevent unwanted lag when opening a window. This is great if you want to browse the internet while downloading your next game. The GX Corner is also a great spot to find some of the freshest games on the market. All of the best and upcoming titles can be found with just a single press on its sleek sidebar. They also have a deals aggregator, perfect for those of us on a tight budget. It's a one-stop shop to find everything gaming-related, such as esports. From catching up to your favorite Twitch streamers, using its free-flowing video pop-outs, listening to favorite tunes in Spotify, or talking to your friends in Discord. It's easily the most accessible and customizable browser right now with a ton of design choices that could fit your gaming style. Maybe syncing those themes with your RGB desktop design. It even has a sweet ambient background music for some soothing browsing and a forced dark mode for those annoyingly bright websites. We've been using the Opera GX for almost a week now and we can't wait to see what more tools are coming soon. For more information, you can check out the link provided in the description box below. Download the Opera GX browser now. Starting off at number 10 is Ori and the Will of the Wisps. The sequel to the award-winning indie platformer from Moon Studios, Will of the Wisps is yet another gorgeous adventure for the forest spirit. It's taking players into uncharted territory, pitting them against ferocious beasts and odd creatures that pose a challenge for the uninitiated. It's still an emotionally riveting experience from start to finish, and its combat is a huge improvement from the first game. It's unfortunate we don't get enough extra chapters as DLCs, but all we can do now is wait for its inevitable threequel. A play score of 9.15. Number 9 is Dusk. Inspired by the shooters of the 90s, David Szymanski's indie FPS packs everything a shooter fan would love about the old classics. Dusk was praised highly for its level designs, which reward your exploration with plenty of surprisingly inventive scenes and cheeky shortcuts and hidden areas. Add its soundtrack and their satisfying gunplay, and it easily becomes an FPS that fans should try at least once. It shows a complete understanding of what it's like to play retro games with rose-colored glasses, and it gets a play score of 9.18. At number 8, we have Celeste. A true test of skill for the platformer veteran, Celeste feels like a literal mountain to overcome with complex levels that demand lightning-fast reflexes and a ton of patience. The game isn't afraid to show moments of vulnerability amidst its hardcore platforming. There will be moments of reflection in each passing chapter, and it shapes our main character's resolve. This is also accompanied by a stellar soundtrack that somehow alleviates the stress and frustration from its puzzles. The game just released its final free DLC titled Farewell, which focuses on Celeste's final message for the fans that helped her on her journey. It has a play score of 9.19. Seventh spot is Return of the Obra Dinn. Lucas Pope has been handing out award-winning puzzlers since 2013's Papers, Please. With this game, he took it up a notch, adding mystery and exploration to his repertoire. The Return of Obra Dinn has been praised for its unique one-bit art style, as well as its storyline that tasks you with determining the fate of everyone on board the eponymous ship. This gives you an unparalleled freedom to solve the puzzles that each passenger's story provides, and finally figuring it all out is as rewarding as it can be. It has a play score of 9.20.
What the?
Number 6 is Resident Evil 2 Remake. Capcom has been on a roll for the past few years, and the future looks even brighter now that Resident Evil Village is nearing its release. RE2 Remake was the first of Capcom's revival of their famed survival horror titles. It's a complete rework of the 1998 classic, bringing in fresh and familiar scares using its impressive RE engine. Its greatest strength comes from its retold narrative, which lets their two perspectives shine in surprisingly new ways. A playscore of 9.21. Number 5 gives us Disco Elysium. One of 2019's standout PC titles, Disco Elysium is not a game for those who want a fast-paced action experience. It's a game that commits to its branching narrative in a pen and paper RPG-like format. As a detective with a knack for mystery, you forge the life of its lowly protagonist as he seeks answers within its weird world. The degree of freedom in each of its well-crafted missions gives you hours and hours of groundbreaking storytelling. Its latest update now has a fully voice-acted game. It has a play score of 9.26. At number 4, we have Stardew Valley. The farming simulation genre completely changed with the arrival of this title from one-man developer Concerned Ape. It improved on every aspect that Harvest Moon introduced while also adding combat and crafting, making it into an all-around title that almost anyone can enjoy. You could even share your farm with friends in co-op. It was first released back in 2016, but there's still a lot to come back for with so many new updates. Its most recent one, giving us new faces, events, and a beach farm. It has a play score of 9.24. Third place is Divinity Original Sin 2. The sequel to Larian Studios' RPG has only boosted everyone's exposure to their very meticulous outlook on the genre. The world is detailed and interactive and has an emergent atmosphere that's open to experimentation. Their lore is heavy with worldbuilding that's only gotten deeper with each update. The definitive edition added new areas and difficulty settings as well as revised dialogue that freshened up the experience all the more. For a relatively young title, it definitely deserves its reputation as one of the best RPGs out there. A play score of 9.37.
Death is your only family. Death and I.
Standing at the number 2 spot is Hades, the award-winning indie action game that won the hearts of many last year. Hades is Supergiant Games' latest opus, and it's one hell of a roguelike game. Pun intended. Escape from the evil clutches of the underworld and rebel against your father Hades. It's a relentless hack-and-slash adventure that lures you with its developing story after every death, and a cast of characters that bring new meaning to the Greek mythos. Packed with a rocking soundtrack, a fully voice-acted cast, and unlimited replay value, Hades deserves a play score of 9.47. Here are the runners-up before we reveal the number 1. Dead Cells. Just when you thought you're awesome at platformers, this game will humble you. It has a play score of 9.15. Slay the Spire. This is not your grandma's card game. You'll want to replay this one again and again because you'll never know what amazing combo you'll get next. It has a play score of 9.13. Day of the Tentacle Remastered. This is how point-and-click games should be made. You'll be laughing for hours and hours from both the wit and the literal potty humor. It has a play score of 9.13. Sekiro: Shadows Die Twice. The best part of this game is definitely the combat. Every time you die, you know it's your fault, which makes winning all the sweeter. It has a play score of 9.12. Hollow Knight. An absolute must play, and not just because it goes on sale often. It can be quite challenging, so you really have to get good. It has a play score of 9.07. Crusader Kings 3. What makes this game special is simply that it focuses on the stories of the characters. Expand and improve your mighty kingdom. Forza Horizon 4. The best PC racing game on whattoplay.com for good reason. Its content and open-world environments makes it practically the perfect racer. Rimworld. A survival sim with a lot of personality and deadly quirks. The learning curve may be steep on this game, but it's oh so rewarding. Baba Is You. Hempuli Oi's reinvention of a puzzle is nothing short of creative. What Remains of Edith Finch? A hauntingly beautiful adventure. If someone tells you that games aren't art, make them play this one.
Well, we've got to get you out of here and up to the roof.
I'm working on it.
And the number one PC game of the last 5 years is Half-Life Alyx. Half-Life's latest chapter shows just how much respect Valve has for the series, giving us a more intimate look at City 17 through the eyes of Alyx in VR. Despite the use of newfangled tech, its gameplay and storyline has so much of the original game's spirit that it's almost impossible not to feel nostalgic. As a prequel, it's best experienced with some knowledge of the events of the main series, as it answers many of our long-held questions while also offering an idea of what's to come in the series. It has a play score of 9.5. Before we end our video, we thank these What to Players for supporting our channel through Patreon. For just a dollar, you can have your name plastered on our video and get exclusive What to Play rewards. Become a certified What to Player and visit our Patreon page, link below.